ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology. Nice to see you back, and I would like to wish each one of you a very, very, very happy Diwali and happy New Year in advance. 2018 is finished, almost just two more months remaining, and we have 2019 here. It has been a crazy year with so many difficult transits and so many difficult nakshatras, so many challenges, and I can see the mails which many of you have been writing to me. Well, I can understand it has been a difficult year, 2017 and 18. Hope that 2019 shall be better, alright? But today we are going to discuss something very important on Diwali, that what's the significance of Diwali? I mean, how to see that astrologically? Now, we all know that when the celebration of Diwali, Sun is in Libra, it's in debility. Okay, oh my god, I forgot to say. If you're new to the channel, then please subscribe to it. And if you like this video, then click the thumbs up at the end and share it with somebody who is interested to know more about Deepavali and astrology. And before I begin, as I always say, God is there with you all the time. Just look to Him and you will find Him. In Diwali, definitely you will find Him. Okay. So, the thing is, Sun is in Libra when Diwali is celebrated. Why? Why is Sun, Surya Narayan, is at its lowest? Why? Because if you recall what actually Deepavali is, Deepavali is the day when Lord Ram had returned to Ayodhya from exile. How many years, my God? And finally he had killed Ravan, and then finally he had entered the holy city of Ayodhya, which I was fortunate to visit exactly a month back around that time. So when Lord Ram had returned that time, it is said that entire Ayodhya was in lights. That is why they celebrate this festival. But the thing is, before that, till one day before of Diwali, I'm talking of the original Deepavali, okay? Deepavali or Diwali, however you call it, North Indian, South Indian, nobody should make a controversy here that you are from North, you are from South. Ha, kya baat hai. North South Indian controversies about Diwali. Okay, so whichever way you call it, one day before the original Diwali, you know, they say that Ayodhya was totally dark. It was pitch dark. When Kaikeyi had said to Dashrath Maharaj that I will not tolerate Ram sitting here in the throne, so Bharat, my son, should sit in the throne, and your eldest son, she said to Dashrath Maharaj, Ram should go to the forest for XYZ number of years. If you know the number of years, then write it in the comments. So then what happened was, then she also said that, yes, so, and that she did when Bharat was outside, you see. Bharat was not there, because if Bharat would have been there, you would have never let that happen. Alright, so when Bharat returned, Bharat came to know what Kaikeyi had asked. So Kaikeyi had asked, first Bharat will become the king, and then Ram has to go to Vanvas, to forest, to exile. And then Bharat came and said to everybody, all the courtier members of the kingdom, that you big fools, you did the opposite. First you sent Ram to the forest and then you made me the king. You should have done the reverse, the one which Kaikeyi had said. You should have first made me the king and then you should have sent Ram to the forest. Because then I would have seen how Kaikeyi would have sent Ram to the forest. She would have never done it if I was the king. But you fools, you have done the reverse. First you have sent him out and now you have put me in the throne. You see, that's terrible. And then Bharat, he did not enjoy the kingdom. He went to a different place. If you know the place, then write it in the comments where he stayed. So he was staying just like Lord Ram. His thought process was that Lord Ram is staying in severe austere conditions. So how can I stay in this luxury? Lakshman and Ram, they are staying in the forest. So I will also live like a renunciate, in a hermit. And from there, he used to carry on the activities of the kingdom of Ayodhya. He was taking all the responsibility perfectly. So the point here is, the people of Ayodhya loved Lord Ram so much that they said that we will stay with you here in the forest and let Kaikeyi and Bharat rule that Ayodhya where there is nobody. Is there any president? Is there any prime minister? Or is there any chancellor? Because I stay in Germany and Germany has a chancellor, Angela Merkel. Is there any leader in this planet or anybody after Lord Ram? Has there been any leader? Of course, maybe Yudhishthira Maharaj is one example. But apart from that, I am asking in contemporary scenario, is there any leader ever to be born who, if he says that I will go to a different place, all the citizens will say, we will also go with you? Is there any person, any king born? No, there's nobody like that. There will be nobody and there cannot be anybody. Because that's only possible if you are Vishnu himself, because then everybody wants to be with you. And then Lord Ram instructed the Ayodhya Vasis that no, your duty is to stay in Ayodhya and to listen to Bharat. So you go and stay in the kingdom of Bharat Maharaj, even if you don't want. It is my instruction that you go and stay there. So you stay there and I stay here. So that is the dedication which the residents of Ayodhya had for Lord Ram. And they were all following severe austerities. They were doing severe austerities. All the people of Ayodhya. What to speak of Bharat Maharaj? What to speak of his wife? What to speak of Shatrughna and his wife? Forget them. These are people from the royal family. I am talking of ordinary citizens. They were also doing the best of the best of the best austerities. Because they were thinking that our object of love is only doing austerity. What is the use of we enjoying, you see? It's so miserable. So if that person who we love so much is in pain, we will also be in pain. We cannot share his pain, but by being in pain, we will also experience, we will also try to share some of his pain. Yes. The current materialistic society, civilization in Kali Yuga is hell-bent on giving pain to others. How to suck the maximum you can from others. But that time Ayodhya was the opposite. So that Ayodhya is the ultimate example of community building. There can be no better example. And on the other hand, Lanka was completely the opposite. Lanka was headed by Ravana, as we all know, where he had looted the wives of many kings and many people, and he had kept them there at his home, at his harem, as his mistress. And he had looted the wealth of so many people. Yes, because you see, the Ravana's mentality was like a supermarket. So wherever he used to go, he used to feel like, oh yeah, you know, when you go to a supermarket, oh yeah, you know, I need this, I need butter, I need this, I need that, I need milk, I need curd. So if you like it, just put it. So once Ravana had gone to the higher planetary systems, and then he had seen Rambha there. Rambha is one of the celestial ladies there. And Rambha was the, daughter-in-law of Kuber. Bahurani, as we say in Hindi. And then he saw Rambha and he got attracted very much. And then he gave a marriage proposal to Rambha. And then when Rambha denied, she said that you are the brother of my father-in-law, for God's sake. You are like my father-in-law, you are like my uncle, you are like my father. How can I marry you? It's not possible. Then Ravana forcefully raped her. Yes, I'm talking of rape here. Ravana raped her, abused her, molested her, whatever you can think Ravana did. And then Rambha's husband, who was the son of Kuber, Nala Kuber, he cursed Ravana that the next time you touch any lady and try to enjoy her, the next time you try to enjoy any lady without her consent, your head will crack into a thousand pieces and you will fall down to the ground dead. So that is the reason why he did not touch Mother Sita, you know. So these days in Facebook, I have been seeing there are many posts which glorify how great Ravana was. So there you go. That's his greatness. So he did not touch, he just did not touch Mother Sita because he knew that if I try to forcefully enjoy with her, then my head will crack into a thousand pieces. So Ravana's Lanka was totally the opposite of what Ayodhya was. So that was the situation of the people of Ayodhya. They were not even eating, it is said. They were barely eating. They were not even drinking. They were barely breathing, it said. Because they could not, it was like Ayodhya was like a haunted city for them, it is said, for the residents of Ayodhya. It was like a smashan, a graveyard. It's like a haunted place. Why haunted? Everything is there. It is said, when Dasharatha Maharaj was the ruler and when Lord Ram was also there, Ayodhya was more prosperous than Amaravati. For God's sake, Amaravati is the place, is the residence of the king of the heavens, Indra. It's one of the very prominent places where he resides full time. So it is said Ayodhya, although it was in this Bhuloka, this earthly realm, it was more opulent, more beautiful, more prosperous than Amaravati itself. It is said that the denizens of the heavenly planets desired to stay in Ayodhya. My God. When the demons would attack, they would come down and ask, seek help from Dasharatha Maharaj that please help us in fighting this demon. We all know that how Shani Maharaj and Dasharatha Maharaj had a fight. And finally, when Shani Maharaj was defeated by Dasharatha Maharaj, stotra is there. You all know that, right? It's a very famous story. We'll speak about that some other time. But the thing is, Dasharatha Maharaj was so powerful. Although he was just like a normal human being, he was not a devata. But he was extraordinarily powerful. And what to speak of Lord Ram, he is Vishnu himself. So that's the thing we see, that Ayodhya was in such a precarious state when Lord Ram was not there. So then when Lord Ram returned, then they started lighting, then they started the celebration, then they started the joy, they started feeling fulfilled again. That same haunted city transformed into Vaikuntha, the spiritual world. Because wherever Lord Ram is, that is Vaikuntha, that is the spiritual world. Wherever Lord Krishna is, that is also Vaikuntha, that is also the spiritual world. There is no difference between that which is there above or that which is in the spiritual realm and that which is here. I mean, provided Lord Ram or Krishna or Vishnu or any of his incarnations, they are there in that place. So that Ayodhya again transformed into the spiritual world. The moment when Lord Ram stepped in with Sita and Lakshman, of course, and Hanumanji and so many other people, of course, who had helped Lord Ram in getting Mother Sita back from the clutches of Ravana. So when Diwali comes, it is not a time to just go to a shop and buy sweets of 3 kgs and go and distribute to your girlfriend or to your mama, chacha, phupha, phupi, mama, mami, all these people. Yes, we can do that. There's no problem. It's not sinful to distribute sweets. I'm not saying that. But instead of doing that, I mean, apart from doing that and celebrating, and apart from going to the movies or taking your girlfriend on a date or putting a tilak and going to a temple, being fake and showing that we are very cultural, we are very nice, we are very much traditional, we are very religious, which many of my friends also do. Yes, on the day of Diwali, those people who are with cigarette and who are with alcohol, you will see them, they are going to the temple and they are like, oh yes, yes, yes. Jai Lakshmi Mata, Maya Jai Lakshmi Mata. This kind of nonsense goes on in Diwali. But when we are talking of serious spiritual cultivation, we should not waste time doing all those things. Which does not mean that we do not do Lakshmi Puja. We do Lakshmi Puja. But when we pray to Goddess Lakshmi for wealth, we should also pray to her that please bestow us with material wealth. But the ultimate wealth that you bestow to everybody is spiritual knowledge. Because have you seen Mother Lakshmi's photo? She is eternally residing at Lord Vishnu's lotus feet. She is always there. So can you imagine, everybody is wanting Lakshmi, but Lakshmi is sitting somewhere else. So this time in Diwali, that is why I made this video early. When you go and attend Lakshmi Puja, either you do it with your heart and soul or you just want to pretend to your parents. Either ways, you get your girlfriend or your wife, your husband, your boyfriend, doesn't matter. But at least pray to her that, just like you always want to stay in Lord Vishnu's feet, please let me also get the desire. Not let me stay there, let me get the desire to stay there. Because if the desire is only not there, how will you pretend that, oh, please let me stay in Lord Vishnu's lotus feet? That's not possible, right? So we can at least pray to her that, please give me the desire that I get the desire to go to him one day. And that is what Sun in Libra shows, that Sun is the natural Atmakarak. What is Atmakarak? Atmakarak is basically, in layman's terms, it shows the soul. So when Sun is in Libra, it shows that the Atma has got involved in so many materialistic things, too many desires, that now the Atma has forgotten its original nature, which is Sat Chit Ananda, full of eternity, knowledge and bliss, three things. Sat Chit Ananda, the Atma has forgotten, and now the Atma is indulging, delighting and wasting time in all these materialistic activities, and nowadays sinful materialistic activities, and the Atma is thinking, oh, I am happy. So today in India, Diwali means what? Like, I have a Diwali celebration program here in Göttingen, Germany. I hope nobody is watching this video. Okay, so there I will go. So what they will do is, they will take something like this, you know, they will take this is called dhoop or agarvati, whatever you say, na. They will take something like this, okay, and then they will put the lighter like this, they will light it like this, okay. So they are going to light it like this. Yay, it's Diwali time, you see, it's Diwali, my God, it's Diwali, yay, it's Diwali, you see, ha, Diwali is finished. So this is how they will celebrate Diwali. On 3rd November in Göttingen, we have this celebration. And then there are ladies who will come wearing saris and salwars, okay? And they will wear tilak, some of them will wear some kind of makeup and beauty, they will come. And then they will say namaste, they will bring 2-3 of their German friends. So Diwali is like a socializing event, there is nothing spiritual there, okay? Unfortunately. But we can decide to make it spiritual, alright? So instead of playing music songs, dhinka chika, dhinka chika, dhinka chika, instead of playing all these things, which we are doing for the rest of 364 days in a year, on Diwali, just like the citizens of Ayodhya had lit up the entire city, my God, because they were so happy that Atma has come back. It's like Ayodhya, the soul of Ayodhya, which was Lord Ram, has finally returned. So let us also celebrate this in a mood that finally, hopefully, one day maybe Lord Ram also returns back to our hearts. Because till the time he is not there in our heart is like Ayodhya actually, before Lord Ram, which is in darkness, you see. That is why you will see suicides increasing, depression is increasing, people are unhappy, they are getting into addictions, they are getting into depression, they are stressed, they are pressed, they are messed, they are depressed, my God. The situation of current materialistic society is no less than Ayodhya when Lord Ram was not there. So on the day of Diwali, let us put the lights, you see, this is going. So let us light diya, lamp, whatever we can. Let us celebrate it with our friends. But at the same time, do spiritual activities and get one step closer to God. Every Diwali, ask yourself this question: has Lord Ram returned to my heart? If no is the answer, then please do something about it. Start chanting mantras in the morning. Go to holy places. You can go to Haridwar. The other day somebody was telling me, why do you only speak of South India and South Indian holy places? Is there no holy place in North India? So I decided in the month of July that I will visit all the places in North India. My God, not all places, of course. I visited Haridwar, Rishikesh I could not visit, then Vrindavan, Mathura, so many places. So you can also visit these places. Alright? Not in Diwali maybe, but in some other time you can visit. And during the New Year you can visit. Then you can go and sit there and talk with the people who belong to the original sampradayas. Yes, the people who are staying there from hundreds and thousands of years, light years maybe, time immemorial. You can talk to the sages, the rishis, the gurus, the munis. You can talk to them, seek enlightenment from them. You can also visit Ayodhya sometimes. Okay, or you can visit Kashi, you can visit there, you can go to the Dashashwamedha Ghat and you can meditate. My God. So do spiritual activities. That's what is the thrust of this message of Diwali. So then the sun, which is debilitated, which is in Libra, will feel its elevation. Otherwise, it will still remain debilitated. So the good thing about the original first Diwali was that Lord Ram returned. But in our case, the problem is we do not want him back. So we do not even invite him, you see. So Diwali is just like, okay, let's blow the crackers. Na? Jagmak, jagmak, jagmak. What is that red color they used to blow in my childhood? I used to see that. So instead of wasting time doing all this, let us take out the Ramayana, let us take out the Ramcharitmanas, or take out the ninth canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, where Sukhdev Goswami is speaking to Parikshit Maharaj. Of course, he doesn't speak much about Ramayana. There he says Valmiki has already spoken. So better you take out Valmiki Ramayana. Or you can take out any canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam. Or you take out the first canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam. And you start reading. Okay. Start from the first sloka. The Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Janmadyasya Yatonvayaditaratascharteshu Bhigyaswarat Tene Brahma Hridayadikavaye Mohyanti Yata Suraya Tejo Varimritam Yatha Vinimayos Tisargo Mrisa Dhamna Svena Nirastakuhakam Satyam Parama Dhimahi. You can start shout it so much that your neighbors come and say, what the hell, man, just stop it. Why are you putting it on loudspeaker? Shout, shout and shout. You keep shouting this sloka, man. Okay, shout it so much that your entire society, as in Hindi they say, na, pura mohalla gussa ho gaya aapse. Okay, so if they are blasting crackers, then you also blast the crackers of Srimad Bhagavatam. Take one shloka. If you don't like this shloka, take another shloka. Narayana para sarve na kutaschana vibhyati swarga pavarga narkeshu apitulya arthi darshinaha. You can take that shloka where Lord Shiva is telling to Parvati that how do people who are Narayan Parayan, how do they behave? Alright, that's there in context of Vritrasur Maharaj. That shloka you can say. Or you can take some shloka from the Gita. Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma na sochati na kangshati sama sarveshu bhuteshu madbhaktim labhate param. How does a great soul behave? And who is a Mahatma? Mahatmanastu mam partha daivim prakritim ashritam bhajanti ananya manaso gyatva bhuta dimavyayam. Yes, who is a great soul? That's who is a great soul. Mahatmanastu mam partha daivim prakritim ashritam. One who takes shelter of my divine potency, my spiritual energy, that, oh Arjuna, is a great soul. Alright. My God, it's too long. So this Diwali, you blast the crackers of spiritual knowledge. Alright? And blast it so loud that all the drums and all the speakers and everything else will fail. And only then, your sun will be elevated. It will not be Libra anymore. It's like sun in Sagittarius or Aries or Leo maybe. Okay? Until next time, have a great Diwali celebration. Attend the Lakshmi, Kuber, Puja, Dhanteras, whatever is there. And when you're praying to Goddess Lakshmi, make sure you also pray to her that please bless me with the real knowledge, with real wealth. Real wealth is the wealth of spiritual wisdom. It is not simply notes and money, car, property. Alright? There you go. If you're new to the channel, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation from me regarding your son, if it's in Libra or some other place, then you can please go to my website and you can book a reading there. You will find the link to the website in the description section of this video below. Okay, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and don't find him, speak about him also. Okay, until next time, happy Diwali, happy new year, happy Dhanteras, bye bye, see you.